and some of them are generals. And then my neighbor down, just right down the road from me, is actually, actually he's one of them that did my testing. He was one of the VECs for the testing. He lives probably maybe not even a half a mile down from me. I've seen some weird antennas in his yard, and I guess now I know what they are. But no, this one here, a friend of mine that's a ham operator. Like I said, he's a general. He doesn't really do much except for 2 meter anymore. And he's wanting to look at getting this one to me, and it looks like it's brand new. There's not a scratch on it or nothing. It looks excellent. And he's asking $600 for it, so is what he's asking for it.
Yeah, well, if it's in good shape, it's been cared for, that's the way to go. I try to keep my eye out for that sort of stuff, too. And, because even if it is used, if somebody cared for it, that they treated it well. And, if it's all beat up and scratched, looks like it's been dropped on the floor, probably not a good choice. I mean, unless you really need to save the pennies on there. But yeah, it sounds, for the type of radio that is and what it could do, yeah, if it's in really nice shape, yeah, that would be a nice one to keep around there for sure. Anyway, so with that, are you going to, you're probably thinking about antenna stuff then in the future if you're going to be upgrading to your general class. Do you have any other antennas other than the PDL-2 there now?
I've got also a ground plane here. It's a Mako ground plane, aluminum ground plane. That, like I said, it's tuned 27 and 28 megahertz also. But I've got on order, let me see what it is. It's I knew what it was before. G5RV. It's just kind of like an all-band ground plane. And the thing I'm worried about most is most of these radios only tune like 3 to 1 or so. And I think I'm going to have to get me an external tuner that does like 10 to 1 so that way I can make sure and cover everything good. So I guess I can do my 10 to 1 tuner and then use a tuner in the radio to kind of fine-tune it, I guess.
Yeah, okay. Hang on a second, Michael. There's somebody else I've heard in there a couple of times. I'm just curious to see who it is. Who's the other station in there?
Kilo 7, Mike Echo.
Oh, hey, Mike. There's my buddy Mike down there. And is it Alabama or Louisiana? I always get it confused. Alabama or Louisiana? Right, Alabama. Okay. Yeah, I hear you in there. I think I heard you in there pop in there a couple of times. Michael, are you able to hear the other mic?
I'm on the beam. I can switch over to the ground plane. I may be able to, but I'm pointed directly up at you, so he's on the back side of my beam right now.
Right, okay. Anyway, real quick, Mike KK7ME. Yeah, so 1 o'clock, so you must have just got off of work? Yeah, I'm doing all right. Yeah, that's Kilo Mike 4, Roger Delta Hotel. He is actually up in Kentucky, and at least I think that's where he's at right now. And so yeah, I think you're far enough south. I don't think you guys are going to be able to hear each other unless it happens to be on backscatter or something. So anyway, yeah, I'm hearing in there. And you're a little light, but I haven't missed a word yet. In any case, so if you've been listening for a little while, how much more time you got before you get home?
About 10 more minutes.
Oh, Roger. Well, is the wife going to let you get on the radio for a minute when you get home? Okay, yeah, probably a good idea, too, anyway, because, yeah, you really faded down in that last one there. So, all right, Mike, we'll talk to you later. Anyway, back over to you there, Michael, KM4RDH, AC7AV. Were you able to pick him up at all?
I switched over to the ground plane. I'm on the ground plane now, and I could hear him talking, but I couldn't quite understand what he was saying. KM4RDH.
Oh, really? Wow, that's amazing. I don't know how far away you are from, he's pretty close to Birmingham, Alabama. How far away are you from there? Is that pretty close?
Not really. I'm kind of where Kentucky and Indiana and Illinois all meet. I'm right around in that area there. So I'd say Birmingham's probably, drive-wise, down 65, probably a good 8 hours or so.
Oh, okay. So it's not even close. Okay. I don't know why I thought you might be closer. I get confused. You know, I'm a West Coast guy anymore. You know, all these states on the East Coast, they're all close together as far as I'm concerned. So, let me just pull up the map here. Oh, yeah, I see. You got a whole state and a half to go through. So, yeah, you must be just hearing them on backscatter or something there. Well, that's good. Well, your vertical's still sounding okay, too. I mean, obviously, you're stronger on the PDL, too. But, you know, it's not too bad. It's not shabby anyway for the conditions that we have right now. Over.
Yeah, I went back to the beam. I've got my beam itself. It's probably 45 or so foot in the air. Then my ground plane itself is, I think the bottom of my ground plane is about 25 feet in the air or so. So I don't figure it's doing too awfully bad considering how tall it is.
Oh, Roger. Well, you're starting to fade down there, so that could be. That could be it for us this evening. I know it happened about the same time yesterday where it just seemed to keep getting lower and lower. And actually, I think it was a little bit later in the day, but I think I held on to it a little bit longer than I normally would. As I think you heard in the recording, it got pretty weak. So in any case, I'll send you a recording of this one here, too, so you can hear what the 920 sounds like. And I put the headphones on to make sure I had you on frequency, so it should make a little bit of a difference anyway. Over. Yep, that's it, Michael. That's it. The band went out on us. 73, till next time, KM4RDH, AC7AV, Green Acres, Washington.